Hey, it's Sly Gittens from Tech Simplified. Ready to take your security to the next level? Today, I'll show you how to set up YubiKey with Microsoft Entra, starting with easy-to-follow slides and then diving into a quick live demo. Let's make passwordless simple and secure, and remember, always be learning. Welcome, everyone. We're about to talk about Microsoft Entra and YubiKey. In this presentation, we'll cover the basics of Microsoft Entra and how it simplifies identity and access management, and how using a FIDO-based security key like a YubiKey can take your digital security to a whole nother level. By the end of this session, you'll be able to understand the key benefits in combining these tools and have a clear step-by-step guide on how to set them up in your organization. Let's explore what Microsoft Entra ID offers and why it's a cornerstone for modern identity and access management. This platform is designed to address the evolving challenges of securing users, devices, and applications in today's hybrid and cloud-focused environments. Identity management is a cornerstone of Microsoft Entra and provides centralized control over users' identities. This means IT administrators can manage how users log in, what they access, and when. By centralizing this process, it reduces the complexity of managing identities across multiple systems and applications. This is especially crucial for organizations with hybrid setups, as it ensures users have seamless access while maintaining strict security. Microsoft Entra is fully integrated into Microsoft ecosystem, working seamlessly with Microsoft 365, Azure, and other cloud services. This integration simplifies deployment and management of organizations already using Microsoft tools. Being cloud-based ensures scalability, meaning it can grow with your organization and adapt to changing needs without requiring significant security. Is at the forefront of Entra design. It offers multi-factor authentication, options to verify users' identities, and conditional access policies to ensure only authorized individuals can access sensitive data and systems. Conditional access allows you to enforce security-based rules on factors like user roles, device status, or geographic location, which is critical for safeguarding against cybersecurity threats. For example, you could block access from an untrusted device or require additional authentication for high-risk actions. Microsoft Entra is more than just an identity solution. It's a comprehensive system designed to protect your organization while providing smooth user experience. Throughout this session, we'll discuss how you can enhance these capabilities by incorporating FIDO tokens like YubiKey for even stronger authentication, and how they complement Entra's features to provide a secure and passwordless future. Let's dive into the concept of two-factor authentication, or 2FA, which is a crucial layer of security protecting your accounts and systems. Two-factor authentication is an additional layer of security beyond just a password. While a password alone can be compromised, 2FA requires a second form of verification to confirm your identity. Think of it as having another lock on your digital doors. So how does it actually work? 2FA combines two elements to verify your identity, something you know, like your password, and something you have, such as a FIDO token, YubiKey, or a mobile app for authentication. For example, entering your password, you may need to insert a hardware token or approve a logon request on your phone and complete the process. This ensures that even if someone has your password, they cannot access your account without the second factor. The biggest benefit of 2FA is reducing the risk of unauthorized access. Even if passwords are stolen or guessed, the additional step makes it extremely difficult for attackers to break in. This extra security significantly lowers the likelihood of breaches and protects sensitive data. 2FA is a foundational security practice. We'll explore how Microsoft Entra integrates with advanced tools like FIDO tokens to make this process even more secure and user-friendly. Let's talk about the benefits of using FIDO tokens like YubiKey with Microsoft Entra. These tokens are revolutionizing how we think about secure authentication, making it just stronger, but also more user-friendly and cost-effective. FIDO tokens provide robust protection against phishing attacks and account takeovers, Unlike traditional methods like password, MS codes, FIDO tokens are tied to a physical device, making them nearly impossible for attackers to compromise. This extra layer of security drastically reduces the chances of unauthorized access. One of the standout benefits is how easy the tokens are to use. It's simple tap and go process. Just plug in the token, tap it, and you're authenticated. There's no need to remember complex passwords or worry about typing errors. This makes the login experience seamless for end users. FIDO tokens also work across multiple devices and platforms. Whether you're using a laptop, smartphone, or a tablet, these tokens integrate seamlessly, providing secure authentication no matter where you are. Compatible with many operating systems, including Windows and macOS. And for IT teams, FIDO tokens are significantly reduced to support calls related to password resets, which are one of the most common IT requests. By eliminating the reliance on passwords, organizations can save both time and money while improving security. Overall, FIDO tokens combined with Microsoft Entra ID provide modern, secure, and efficient ways to manage authentication for individuals and organizations alike. As we move forward, we'll explore how to set up and implement these tokens effectively. Let's start by understanding FIDO and YubiKey, two components in modern secure authentication systems. FIDO, which stands for Fast Identity Online, is an open authentication standard designed to enable secure, passwordless logins. Instead of relying on traditional passwords, FIDO uses strong cryptographic protocols that authenticate users through physical devices or biometric. This eliminates the vulnerabilities of passwords such as being guessed, reused, or stolen. YubiKey is a physical security key that implements FIDO protocols. It acts as a second factor, or sometimes even replacing the password altogether. Users can plug a YubiKey into a USB or use it with an NFC, a mobile device, to confirm their identity. It's compact, durable, and incredibly easy to use. And the other thing is enhanced security, ease of use, universal compatibility, meaning that it can work with various tools for securing both personal and organizational accounts. In essence, FIDO and YubiKey are game changers for identity access management, ensuring stronger security while improving the user's experience. We'll see how to integrate these tools like Microsoft Entra ID to deliver these benefits in practical scenarios. Let's dive into the demo. And if you want these slides, head over to Tech Simplified and go to training. This will be here with the videos, with the slide decks. You can have access to the slides with my notes. First place we're going to go to is entra.microsoft.com. Sign in. And then when you get to the home page, go to authentication methods. When you get here, you're going to see these built-in ones. Turn on passkey. That's FIDO token. And make sure you click enable. You can do it for all users. Usually, I don't see passkeys in production environments for every user. Would it be best practice? Yes. Will you get some pushback? Yes, because it's a little bit slower to remember a key. I find that mostly administrator accounts or higher level executive accounts will have these on. So select the group and pick the group from there. And then there's another thing. Once you enable it, you can allow for self-service. Yes, we want to do that. Do we want to block other keys? We can say yes. In this case, I want to say no because this is my protection environment. What that means is that's the public number that shows if this is an actual safe key, right? You can have that information there. So you can always click to learn more to go deeper in each of these sections, but that's what we're going to do for now. Let's click out of that. After we built that, what do we do next? I like to go to authentication strengths. Why? This is cool because when you go on authentication strengths, it lets you pick what do you want to use for authentication. I want to use YubiKeys because that's a little bit higher level. Now you got to have the key also and know my password, which is going to happen. So you can do password keys. You click there. And we click advanced options. You want to restrict keys. You can also put password, Microsoft push authentication. If you want to have that option, you can do software, hardware token. You can do temporary access. Some accounts want hardware tokens. You can make the ones for different areas. If you want all your administrators to have the YubiKey, you can have that. If you want multi-factor throughout everything, you can pick those. It gives you the ability to pick and choose how you want to set it up for your conditional access policy. Once we click next, it's saved. We're going to go back to home. Then we're going to go to conditional access. We're going to create a policy that now incorporates that password strength. So let's go here. And I already created one just for time's sake to keep this demo a little bit more manageable. click the name, MFA for all. In your case, be as specific as you want. I made sure to include all users, but I did exclude a few users in there just in case I did something wrong and I locked myself out. I have a way to get out of it. Always do that. Test it. You can put in report only mode in the beginning to make sure, but always exclude at least an account, an admin account, so you don't get locked out. You can target specific resources. We're not going to talk through all these options today. I'm going to make an updated conditional access training where we just talk about conditional access. I'm going to say grant access, not required. Multi-factor authentication will require authentication strength. And that's the one we created. Remember the YubiKey? It has all that things in there. We're going to require that selected controls. Clicks. And now we have created our policy to enforce using that password strength. Now we're going to add that YubiKey to my account. So let me go ahead and do that. We talked about enabling the passkey for FIDO, then creating a password string to include FIDO in it, then creating a conditional access. And now I'm going into my account to mysignin.microsoft.com. And this is going to give me the ability to add another sign-in method. What we want to do is create, you could use a security key, or if you're a face, fingerprint, pin, actual security key. That's what we're going to use in this case. We're going to be using these YubiKeys to log in. Or you can use a hardware token, phone, or email. I don't really like using email because that's pretty easy to spoof. So let's go ahead and click on that security key. I'm going to be using a USB device right now. And then have your key ready. I'll click next. I'm going to open up my YubiKey. You can see it. It's right here. Let's choose where you want to save this YubiKey. We're going to have an actual security key. Let's set up your key. So let's do that right now. Okay. What we're going to create a pin for it. Let's do that. I'm going to touch my security key. Now I can use my security key to sign in. You're going to name it. You're going to call this YubiKey. I'm going to call it P1. So that's my primary. It's always best practice to have a secondary key just in case I can't get in. In this case, I also have the ability to log in with my multi-factor authentication push notification, but I can delete that. So I don't have that option. I'm going to keep that on for right now. The next time I sign in, I will be able to use that key. Let's test that out. Now let's sign back into our account. When we get here, you put in your username. Before you put in your password, say pause and go to user face security key instead. That's what we're going to use. Let's go use our security key. Click next. Make sure we write in our PIN. Okay. Then I got to touch my key. And now it's going to ask me, do I want to stay in? And we just used our hardware key to log into my account. Let's recap what we covered today. We explored the basis of two-factor authentication, learned about the benefits of FIDO tokens like YubiKey, and walk through how to set up YubiKey with Microsoft Entra. With these tools, you're equipped to enhance your security and embrace the future of passwordless. To dive deeper and access the slides from this training, head over to www.sgtechsimp.com/training. Thank you for joining me. And as I always say, always be learning.